Hi, boys and girls. Welcome back to Penny's Reading Nook. I'm here for the Patch Office in Spencer, West Virginia. And, well, if you look at the table, looks like we might be kind of busy this morning. What do you think? I think so. And if you look, I've got some spider stuff. So I kind of wonder. I've got paint and spider rings and paper and I just have all sorts of exciting things here. So you probably want to say, Miss Penny, you really need to stop talking and get along with this activity so we can see the spiders and we can learn some fun stuff, right? Right. See, I'm reading your mind. I've got this down. So let's start off our spider adventure with a book called The Very Busy Spider. This book was written and illustrated by Eric Carle. I really like Eric Carle's books that he makes. It's called The Very Busy Spider. Early one morning, the wind blew a spider across the field. A thin, silky thread trailed from her body. The spider landed on a fence post near a farmyard and began to spin a web with her silky thread. "Nay, nay," said the horse. "Want to go for a ride?" The spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Moo," said the cow. "Want to eat some grass?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Baa," bleated the sheep. "Want to run in the meadow?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. Do you see her web? She's getting lots of little details to it, huh? "Meh, meh," said the goat. "Want to jump on the rocks?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Oink, oink, oink," grunted the pig. "Want to roll in the mud?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. You see how she's starting to add more and more details each time. "Woof, woof, woof," barked the dog. "Want to chase a cat?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Meow. Meow," cried the cat. "Oh, want to take a nap?" But the spider didn't answer. She was very busy spinning her web. "Quack, quack," called the duck. "Want to go for a swim?" The spider didn't answer. She had now finished her web. You see that's the web? Lots of details in there. "Cock-a-doodle-doo," crowed the rooster. "Want to catch a pesty fly?" And the spider caught that fly in her web, just like that. "Who? Who?" asked the owl. "Who built this beautiful web?" But the spider didn't answer. She had fallen asleep. It had been a very, very busy day. The end. And that was The Very Busy Spider by Eric Carle. All right. At my classroom and building blocks, I have a box full of animal fact cards. And I went through my fact cards and I was looking for some different pictures of spiders that I could show to you. Now, this first one, oh, I have a horrible time pronouncing the name. I believe it's an Agriobi spider. My friend Pam, that I work with at Building Blocks, she used to live in Georgia, and she said this spider is also known as the zipper spider. Do you have any ideas why this one might be called the zipper spider? If you look real close at its spider web, it looks like a zipper, okay? And then we have the American house spider. We have the grass spider. Ooh, you ready to see this one? Ugh. We have a tarantula. I don't know about that one. And then we have a wolf spider. And those were the cards that was in my box of animal facts. And then on the back of them, we can read some different things. It says that this Agriobi spider, I'm going to call it the zipper spider. Okay, the zipper spider is an arachnid. Now, do you guys know what an arachnid is? It is different from an insect. An insect has three body parts. It has a head, a thorax, and an abdomen. An arachnid, and an insect has six legs. Arachnid has only two body parts, the head and the body, and they have eight legs. Okay, so an insect's gonna have six legs and three body parts and either one or two pair of wings, and then arachnid is going to have eight legs and only two body parts, okay? Now, this zipper spider likes to live in the forest. He says, I am a carnivore. Do you guys know what a carnivore is? It's a meat eater. It says, I have an exoskeleton. I have eight legs. I like to walk. And then we have a couple of interesting facts about them. The zipper spider spins a very large orb web, as big as 2 feet across. Whew, can you imagine that? Get you a tape measure and measure out 2 feet. And that's how big that spider web's gonna be. Don't think I wanna walk into that spider web, do you? Nope. And then the most common of those spiders is a large orange garden spider, okay? And then we have the American house spider. All right. An interesting fact about house spiders are male and female house spiders often live together on the same web, and spiders use silk, which they spin from organs in their abdomens to wrap up their prey. And it says this house spider likes to live in domestic habitats, so it's going to be around their houses, right? Okay, then we have the tarantula. An interesting fact about tarantulas, they are fast-running, hunting spiders that do not spin webs. Some tarantulas live more than 20 years. Can you imagine a 20-year-old tarantula? Whew, not me. Don't want to meet that fella. I'll just leave him in the desert where he belongs. Just stay over there, right? Right. All right. The next spider we had was a grass spider. And the grass spider, it says, like all spiders, grass spiders have eight eyes. Did you guys know that? Did you know that a spider has eight eyes? I did not. I did not know that. And a grass spider's flat web is not sticky. And they like to live in the grasslands. And then we have, the last one we have is a wolf spider. The wolf spider got its name because it runs down its prey instead of trapping them in its web. Ooh, that's interesting. And it says wolf spiders are most active at, at night. Okay. Ooh, I'm going to sleep at night, so that wolf spider and I, we don't have anything to worry about, do we? No. And I probably should have went over something in a little more detail, and I did not. And I apologize for that, boys and girls. I should have went over each one of the things where, like, this wolf spider is an arachnid, so remember, two body parts. They live in the forest. There's a carnivore. And the word I did not go over with you was an exoskeleton. Do you guys know what an exoskeleton is? Well, an exoskeleton is, it has an external skeletal structure. So let's see if you can find one. And it's kind of like you can see their structure, their skeleton structure on like the outside of their bodies. Okay. So I hope you learned a few things about spiders. I did. I did not know spiders have eight eyes. So they can see everything going on, can't they? They can. And that a tarantula can live to be 20 years old. Whew, that's a lot. All right, so let's move on with that. So we've had our book, we learned some facts about spiders, so now we need to make something. We need to make a spider, right? Well, right here I've got a spider web, and if you look real closely, look at my spider. It has an orange jewel for its body. So you're probably wondering, so Penny, how did you make that spider web and spider? Well, guess what? I'm going to show you. First thing we need to get a black piece of construction paper and a pie plate from your mom's kitchen or your dad's kitchen. That's the cooking at your house. All right, and then we're going to trace around the bottom. Okay, you're going to turn your pie plate over. Ooh, just got glitter everywhere. We're going to trace around the bottom of our pie plate. I'm going to trace with a pencil so I can see around it. Okay, so we've got our pie plate traced. We have a circle, and then we need to cut our circle out. So do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Cut out a circle, da-da-da-da-da, open and shut, follow the lines, kind of cutting and turning your paper at the same time. Easy way to cut a circle. All right, so we have our circle cut, right? And then we get our pie plate back, and we're going to put our black circle right inside of the pie plate. And you also want to make sure it's okay with mom or dad that you use this pie plate because it's going to get some paint inside of it. So we'll want to throw the pie plate away afterwards. Okay, so next you're going to need some white paint. Okay, so I've got my white paint, and then you need some marbles. Hopefully you didn't lose your marbles. All right, and I've got one large marble, and I'm going to dump that in my paint. And then I've got a small marble, and in my paint it goes. Okay. Then I'm going to get a plastic spoon, and I'm going to try to cover our marbles up with the paint. Okay. And when you get them covered up, we'll start off with the big one. You take it out of your paint, and you're going to put it on your black paper and your pie plate. And now the fun happens. Now you're going to take your pie plate, and you're going to move it around back and forth, just like the busy spider did in the Eric Carle book. And you're going to spin your web. But you want to try not to get it to go back and forth. Tell you what, that fat marble, the big marble, it really did a good job making the spider web, didn't it? All right, so we're going to pull that one out. And let's take the little marble just to see what the little marble will do too. So you take the little marble out of the paint, drop it on your in your pie plate, and then around and around you go, back and forth, do-do-do-do. All right, I think I have been a very busy spider. I have a very busy spider web. So we take the marble out, okay, and then you don't have to put glitter on yours, but I had some iridescent glitter, so it kind of sparkles. You're going to take some of that glitter. You're just going to sprinkle on your paint. And I did that inside my pie plate. Okay. And then when you're done, now here comes the tricky part. Now we got to try to get that black circle out of our pie plate. Shake all the glitter off. So see, it's not a real messy activity. There's a little mess, but we can keep it contained inside the pie plate. Okay. So I've got my spider web right there. And then I went to Dollar Tree, and at Dollar Tree they had spider rings. Well, the spider rings they had this year have an either purple stone for their bodies or an orange one. So what you're going to do is you're just going to take your spider ring, and you're going to get out your scissors again. And you see the back part where you have the spider ring? We're going to cut that part off. Do-do-do-do. Now watch, my little black pieces are going to fly everywhere. If that one went across the screen there, and that one did too. Okay, so now I have a flat spider, and then I need some glue. I got some tacky glue. I like this tacky glue. It's a little thicker than regular glue. And then we're going to decide where are we going to put the spider. On my first one I did, I put it right on the edge. And I think this purple spider, I'm going to put it right there in the middle. So you put a dot of glue, and then you just glue on your very busy spider. Ta-da! That's it. So with just a few things that you may already have at home, some construction paper, paint, marbles, run down to your local store, find some spider rings. It's getting time of the year where all the stores are having out their Halloween decorations, so it should be easy to find some spider rings and have a great time with it. Use your imagination. Let your imagination go wild with painting of your spider webs. So, with all that, boys and girls, I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.